All right, this is the worst video of all time. The only way to top it is with this video right here, because after a brief hiatus, how did we get canceled? How did we get canceled when we're our own show and we're not making any money? And more importantly, how do we come back from the grave? You're watching the BB Live Show, the Ridiculous Hair Edition. I'm your host, Brian Brushford. I put the BB into the BB Live Show. See, there's the BBs. No N's, S's, F's, or W's. Joined by the original crew, the real guys, before we sold out and got all corporate. In fact, we're going back to our criminal roots with Justin Robert Young. What's up, Justin Robert Young? Jury duty.
What's up, N-words?
You know what? That's how we'll know that's gone mainstream, is when black people call each other N-words. Like, you know, what's up, my N-word?
Robo-Trekker's back!
Oh, look at that!
Yeah, hey!
Of course we got Robo-Trekker. We're kicking it old school this evening. The original fail.
TSS Holly is pointing out that there is, in fact, an S and a W in BB Live Show.
Oh, man, come on. Nah, there's just this two giant rotating bees. That's all there is. It's about the birds and the bees. I got to show off my new meat, which sounded worse than I meant for it to.
Show off Chad Ochocinco.
We got Chad Ochocinco, Chad Johnson, my new intern on the road. How the hell did you get shenanigized into actually being employed by me? What the hell was that all about?
Money was involved.
Yep, there is money. Is that turned on?
Is it?
And course credit? I don't know. Just talking. Yeah, there you go. You sound great.
Awesome.
You sound fantastic, boss. All right, guys.
This is the funny, Chad.
Funny or fired in 3, 2, 1,
and go.
I didn't know you could get course credit for middle school. That's awesome.
That's he looks like he's in middle school. You're not in middle school, right? You're in college age, right?
Yeah.
All right.
You didn't lie to Brian, did you?
No, it does not.
No,
are those really your glasses?
Make you look older.
Oh, man. All right. Well, we'll have to talk about those.
How pissed was Rick Moranis when you ripped him off?
Rick Moranis. That's awesome. All right. So let's do this. What are we going to do this episode? This is a no agenda, low pressure deal, because with NSFW, it's all about like, okay, be funny and awesome and everything has to work in go and you're live and don't screw up and pressure and sponsor. And so this is none of those things. This is NSFW's on a break tonight because Twit is actually at the CES. I almost went to the CES, Justin.
Did you?
I almost just kind of up and bought a ticket. I don't know.
Like
just
for no reason?
Well, no. Well, first of all, it's the CES. It's in Vegas, right? So you can do worse than go spend time in Vegas for fun. Second of all, it's like, what a surprise to the boss. If you just showed up, you're like, what's up, boss? I'm here. I'm ready to cover your gadgets and your gizmos. For the CES.
Can we do the CES report on BB Live Show tonight, though? Because I have some notes.
Do you? Really?
Yeah, from CES.
Hold on. Yeah, no, that sounds great. What do you got?
I think right now, really, the 3D remote controls are really impressive. I went down to the booth that had a mechanical duck. The market next year.
The highlight of the show, definitely the holographic can opener.
Yeah,
that
definitely.
Was my favorite thing.
I think I'm not sure on the price point there, but I think they got some great stuff.
It's
I'm
a
under
game
NDA on a lot of stuff, including a vibrating elephant. And
that's just a live elephant that they fed crack to.
Exactly. And a bomb that explodes into light.
they're having a hard time in the chat room. There are multiple events going on right now. They don't know if you're talking about the CES or the AVNs with your vibrating elephant.
Oh, no, that's a crossover device. It's what we refer to in the industry as a crossover device, but I wasn't allowed to talk about it because I'm under NDA.
NDA, of course, NDA disclosure. All right, so let's do this. Let's talk about...
Can we introduce Amtrekker, by the way?
Right.
Did you do your introduction?
No. He talked and I cut to him and I just assumed we had... Hold on. Let me start. Hang on. Start it. Hold on. Let's start. Let's start it again.
Oh, no.
No. We got it. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the BB Live Show featuring the one, the only, the inimitable, the one of a kind, the man himself. It is Chad Ochocinco. How you doing, Chad?
Woo!
Oh, I'm sorry. Great. It's Amtrekker. It's Brett Rounceville, a.k.a. the Amtrekker. How have you been, Amtripsical?
I've been awesome. It's been nothing but a nonstop thrill ride here on the westest of coasts.
On the westest of coasts. I think Hawaii would have something to say about that.
Yeah, asshole.
Yeah, that's way to impugn the homeland of our president, jerk.
I know. He's carefully deliberating.
Let's do this.
I have nothing against Kenya's West Coast. That is not a problem.
What are you? Oh, you birther. Get out of here.
What if that's what the topic of the BB Live show was we made our impassionate plea for the birther cause. We all came out really hard in favor. By the way, can we do that on Beer Diplomacy on Thursday, Brian?
Do what?
Can we be like way birther and just
completely
sidetrack
totally
the entire
straight.
Argument?
We could do totally straight.
Please play it straight.
That would be awesome, dude. And we're just like freaking just obstinate too. Like, nope, didn't happen.
What really, when you look on the internet, show me
birth
a birth certificate
right here.
Can you find it?
just whatever he says, be like, show me a birth certificate. Conversation's over. Show me a birth certificate. He's like, well, Brian, that's not the. Show me a birth certificate. That's all you gotta do, man. Show me the birth certificate.
I don't know why you're even talking if you don't have the certificate.
And then we give the dual West Coast. We're just like, what's up? you know what? Talking about West Coast, East Coast rivalries, we got a real. There's a bit of a pickle going on, right?
Oh, are we pickles. Getting to that now?
I mean, I want to, but you tell me.
I don't
me.
Know
Do
if
you
I even want to. If I even want to dignify, you know, such once proud luminaries of tech, entertainment, television, with such a, you know, really, it's so hard. You know, like nobody makes David Lee Roth jokes anymore because, like, really. You know, what are you going to do? You're going to kick the guy after he's obviously flamed out so many times?
Like, you know, I don't know. I mean, it's like, look, it's I don't care if you're a hobo with three legs or no legs, but if I'm walking out of the bar and you wipe your feces-stained hand on my nice jeans, I'm afraid that demands a response. You just don't let that go unanswered, right?
No, I guess not. I just really, I feel sad for them more than anything else. I mean, obviously, this is one of those things where, you know, we're new baby on Twit, and now all of a sudden, middle child has to go, hey, I can tap dance too. I can tap dance too. Look at me, daddy. Look at me.
No, that's
true. But no, we're new hotness.
That's true. That's true. And I tell you what, we actually have some audio. Now, you look like you have no idea what we're talking about, Brett. Did you hear about this?
I have an inkling. I have this page open right now that has a couple of acronyms v a couple of other acronyms.
Okay, well, hold on. Hold on.
That's
well,
where we're
I mean,
going
let's, take,
this.
Let's take a listen
Started
here.
This program called NSFW.
Right?
Why are we talking about that?
Right now,
a competitor show? Brian
I don't think
Brushwood.
It's a competition. I don't think it's no. a competition. At least I didn't think it was a competition until this magician, this
spiky-haired dude,
this trickster, mm-hmm. Brian Brushwood, starts talking smack about us.
What?
Yeah.
All right, Brian, stop the clip. Stop the clip right there.
What?
Can we restart it where it is?
Yeah. Yeah.
Can we go there? Okay, number one, nobody talks smack about him. He took drunken offense to a harmless scientific fact.
Right, and what was the scientific fact? You said, ladies and gentlemen, it is important that we tell the truth in Twitter. There's far too many lies, and it's time for us to report as factual fact what? What did you tell everyone to say?
That and this is people are still they've been doing it all week and you're more than willing to do it or you should do it right now that NSFW is the best show sponsored by Ford Sync My Ride podcast.
Right, because that's the thing is Ford is sponsoring all the shows on Twit, and so we just wanted to say flat out for the hashtag Sync My Ride podcast, you know, just say you know, guess what, NSFW is the best of all shows that are sponsored by Sync My Ride Podcast. I don't think that's, I mean, this, and P.S. the sky is blue.
Yeah, duh. Hey, who's breathing oxygen? These guys. All right. Of us, right now.
Right, exactly.
It's just the world we live in. By the way, praise be to Kuhan. He just sent me maybe my new Twitter avatar.
Really?
He just sent me a Photoshop that is so delightful. I can't even talk about it. Anyway, all right, so that. All of a sudden, as if you know, from some you know, a portrait, a metaphor for American society in the economic downturn, Martin Sargent, you know, puts his drunken hand on his cell phone and decides to take offense to this scientific fact.
Right.
And he reads our show bullshit.
And it's one of those things where it's just like, why so sensitive, right? He reads NSFW is the best show sponsored by Sink My Red Podcast, and he's just like, what is this horse pucky? Only he used dirty words, which we would never do on a show called NSFW, sir. Yeah. We're appropriate for prime time. And so he sort of launches it out. And so meanwhile, I'm just like, hey, man, I just love all America. And I think everyone should get along, and nobody should punch children. And he responds,
he didn't. His
little wizard's apprentice, I don't know what the hell this kid's name is, something.
He's a hack.
They've been talking. They're saying that they're the best show on the network. And apparently they were in the chat room last night, and they recorded a show last night, and they were saying all sorts of terrible. I just don't get it, because I started Brushwood's career.
All sorts of terrible, all sorts of terrible truth. Like, we're just the best show sponsored by Sink My Ride Podcast.
I know. And the other really interesting part of that statement is he started Brian's career.
Well, he did.
Past tense. He doesn't start careers at Revision 3 anymore, does he?
Oh, man, now that's low. That's not appropriate. What is that? Are you calling out the fact that he used to be an employee of Revision 3 and that's not fair.
I'm just saying.
Don't do that.
He said he started.
Okay, look.
I don't know. No.
Listen. I understand. We walked out of the dance club wearing our awesome Armani Gucci loafers, and the hobo with three legs smeared his crap-stained fingers on them. I understand you got to kind of kick him in the face a little bit. But you don't have to pull out a knife and stab him in the brain, all right? That's a little bit far.
Hey, listen, I don't know a lot about Martin Sartre. I'm just asking questions. Maybe he is. Is he? I don't know.
All right, let's hear.
Okay, Brushwood.
Wasn't for me, Scam School never even would have got greenlit.
Hold on. He still greenlight shows at Revision 3, right?
Oh, come on. Would you stop with that? That's not fair. Stop that.
What?
No,
I don't know. I'm not inside Revision 3.
No. Look. Martin's a real deal. He's the one. All right, hold on. We already got people calling in. They can't even contain themselves. Caller, you're on the air. What's up, boss?
I want to know, how did Martin Sargent start your career?
I tell you what. You'll listen to your answer off the air.
Started,
yeah, he started my career, I guess, a decade after I started my career. And then I asked, hey, would you like this project called Scam School to be on Revision 3? And he was my boss, which adds an interesting wrinkle. Martin was my boss. All of a sudden, I'm not comfortable having this conversation. For somebody, that's how loyal an employee I am. I don't even like talking to my former boss this way.
For all I know, he's still your boss, right? Is he your boss still?
No. No, he's not my boss.
Oh. How does that work?
What? He used to be my boss, but now he's not my boss.
No, he's not. So
right.
He probably left because he's got a
Brian.
Brother.
All right, hold on. Jay's on the line. Butter brother, what's up? Parquet, go.
All right, listen. You started your career when I started my career. When we were living next door to each other, you quit your job at Dell, went Magic Mainstream. I didn't have a job, and I went into video games. Listen, the fact is that you're the shit, and you know. Oh wait, I'm sorry. This isn't NSFW. Can I curse?
Yes.
Well, you can curse more than you can. Ironically, you can curse more than you could on the actual NSFW show. So.
All right. Well, fucking A. You did the trick. You got that shit done.
All right.
You fucking bailed it out.
Hang
you
on. Let's
did it.
Let's
you
just.
Fucking,
all right.
You know. But it wasn't Martin Sargent. You caught him out of your fire.
All right. There we go.
There
all
we
right.
go. Cut a promo, Jay. Speak the truth.
All right, well, let's listen to what else they say.
Yeah.
Abracadabra.
What are you going to do, cast the magic missile at me?
I will.
I think it's important to note that, well, we have never mentioned NSFW on
except
our show.
Except for now. Yeah, that's true.
Except
for
be pretty
now,
preoccupied
with
the first us,
time
so,
on the you, podcast.
Yeah,
you
no.
Know, we didn't mention. We weren't out there shouting and yelling, Martin and what is it, Sarah? Is it Sarah?
By the way, hold on, real quick. Chat room, like Martin, and says, "What are you gonna do? Fire a magic missile?" And in the chat room, Vincent 404 says, "That's at least 1d4 of damage." So I mean, don't discount the magic missile.
So did you guys even mention TWIF and all this hoopla? Were the words
TWIF
after
show?
No. Yeah, we said. We're the best show on that's sponsored by this, because we didn't just say on Twit. We said we're the best show sponsored by Ford, period.
Right.
Which is a scientific fact. I don't know how many times Obama went and picked up that Nobel Peace Prize for one reason, because he was the one to discover that we were the best show sponsored by Ford. Everybody knows it. It's a logical fact. There's no dispute.
Slam dunk, motherfucker.
So, and then all of a sudden, we get, you know, the Boohooathon 8000. Raga. I used to be your mom.
It's middle child syndrome. It really is just them saying, like, oh, look, I can make a painting. I can make a painting, Daddy. And they're just smearing paint all over the wall.
They're spilling shit all over the wall. Look, I'm important, too. All right, hold on.
You know how that goes? When you really like somebody, you know, you tend to drop their name quite a bit. First time I'm thinking about him, Sarah? Okay, guys, you got my attention. Good on ya. Little brushwood. So cute.
I'm an illusionist.
Hold on. Do you hear that? Sarah Lane thought I was cute. I just want to throw that out there.
Number one, she very, you know, in a very Freudian sense, says you only talk about somebody when you actually kind of secretly like them.
And then she talks about our show the whole time, right? What's up with that?
Well, listen, hey, we didn't put any of the time on our podcast. The precious time that is allotted to us by King Leo and his cottage. we do not spend any of the time talking about their show. But how long did they spend cutting a promo on NSFW on the new hotness?
Look, man, when you got a hot air balloon and it's filled with rocket sauce straight to the moon, you make sure to put your fish hook on the bottom of that Velcro.
Exactly.
That's a common expression, right?
No, that's basically what's happening. Brett, an unbiased third-party observer, how do you parse this stuff from Twit?
Clearly, they have something going on. There's this inherent, I'm not good enough in their hearts, or else they wouldn't even bring this up, right?
Like, that's a big departure from their normal MO on that show. Normally, their MO is all about bluster and how awesome they are. No self-deprecation on that show.
Well, that's just covering up their insecurities. Now they're bringing their insecurities to the limelight. Fact?
Yeah, sure.
I think that's clear. I think it's very clear. And by the way, I listened to a few This Week in Funds, all right? And normally, they go after shows that are, you know, just caged deers. You know, Martin Sargent walks around with a scattergun looking to take shots at people like Paul Theroux on Windows Weekly, and he calls all the other shows boring. So if he thinks he can run that kind of noise on NSFW, he's got another thing coming.
He didn't realize, dude, he's running up against Craven the Hunter. We'll drink our jungle juice, put on our awesome lion head vest, and we'll freaking mount your head on a pole in my living room.
That's
a common expression.
I agree with all of that.
That's what Craven the Hunter did. If you don't,
I remember.
Okay. All right. Good. All right. Listen.
And I had to stop.
Some people have it. Some people don't. You know, I appreciate those kids trying to keep up. Whatevs. You do your thing. I'm better than you.
Big words, Miss Lane.
Oh, come on! Really?
Wow, that just
really.
Happened.
Oh, that just happened. Come on.
Now, let me ask you a question. Sarah Lane used to have a show on Revision 3, right?
Do not go here again. Listen, I understand.
Because you still have a show on Revision 3.
No. I understand. So
you're on Twit.
Yeah.
And she's on Twit.
Yeah.
And you have
a
show on Revision 3.
Yeah.
And she used to have a show on.
That's another lowball.
That's better than you.
That's not
that
okay.
I don't know. I'm trying to make the math add up, Brian. I'm just trying to make the math add up.
It's like we walk out of the nightclub with our awesome silver laced pants that were forged by ancient dwarves and are unavailable for any cost. And then the hobo smears the feces on him, and then the hobo's mistress asks us, "Got to spot a heroin, governor?" And then you just whip out a knife and stab it in her brain as well. That's too much, man.
I'm just a guy in the world trying to make sense of his surroundings. I'm asking very fair questions, I think.
All right, fine.
So I'm not real good with analogies, but just to clarify, Sarah Lane is the Cockney crack whore.
Yeah,
in
she's
this one?
The Cockney heroin addicted crack whore who asks politely, "Got a spot of heroin, governor?" And then gets stabbed in the brain by a very angry, very
This is the face of an angry man.
An angry man does not dress like he's about to steal jewels. Like, did you? I just pictured to the right of you is a suitcase with $1 million and a mountain of uncut diamonds. Is that a fact?
No, I mean, like, maybe a car stereo, but like
an XM car stereo.
It's only because I'm trying to get some sweet revenge for my XMs.
This is when we find out that you actually, that Fight Club twist, you're the actual one who stole your own car stereo.
Exactly. Invisible Wife points out in the chat room that she didn't know that so many hobos hung out outside of bars where opulent patrons were constantly walking out.
Dude, everyone knows that. Come on.
Yeah, go where the money is when you're a hobo.
Oh, yes. Actually, there is. And it's called the wrist of it.
Oh, wait, yeah. This is actually the one part of this that Martin really did well.
Burns me up. Abracadabra. What are you going to do? Cast a magic missile at me?
I think it's important to note that, well, we have never mentioned NSFW on our show.
Hold on. Unfortunately, this is too loud.
I'm better than you.
There we go.
Oh, look, there's nothing right up here. My sleeve. There's nothing up my sleeve. Oh, yes, actually there is, and it's called the wrist of an a-hole.
that was a proper moment, and for that we should give you, you know, kudos to you, three-legged bum with chit-stained fingers. You exactly. did have one.
You know, you gotta wonder, though, what it's like when a guy is, you know, he's used to saying funny things every time he opens his mouth, starts saying them once every three or four times. Like Martin is now. You know, when there's such a deceleration in his career where it used to be that he could handle an entire late night show.
All right, these are all unfair. These are you can insult his hairstyle because that's what I'm used to. You can insult his comedic wits, but career's below the belt because I plan to have beef.
He doesn't even know my name. Who knows if this will even ever get back to him? Nobody knows who I am.
Yeah, because on the internet, nothing gets back to anyone. Nothing gets back to anyone on the internet. Well, let me tell you this. There's some stuff that happened quite spontaneously on the internet, which I wasn't going to bring this out right now, but it does. Hold on, Jay's calling in real quick. Jay, you got 2 seconds, man. What's up, buddy? Go.
Look, I gotta say, Justin, you're out of line. I can't describe it. I mean, it's professional courtesy and everything.
Dude. Look, I plan to be fired by Twit eventually, and you're gonna be fired by Twit eventually.
So, oh, surely.
Well, so why are you hating on people who got fired before? That's not appropriate.
Well, number one, I'm hating on people who got fired from Revision 3. And I think downsize would be a more humane term.
Oh, humane. Okay, no. I'm not. No more talk of this. I'll have no more because that. That's...
Number one, all I'm doing is asking questions to a torrent of insults, churlish invectives, sent from Twiff to us. I'm just asking.
Well, you don't need to return in kind. In fact, I'm going to say I don't want to have any part of it. I think we are better than the kind of people who would directly insult other people. And you know why? Because there are people who so passionately love NSFW, who so clearly think it is the best show sponsored by Ford, that used to be sponsored by Ford. I don't know if the sponsorship's going to January or not. But I do know that we are the best show that was sponsored in the month of December in the entire world by Ford.
Yes.
And completely on their own, people are sending me pictures like this. And I'm just like, well, this is weird. And then you go down and then it says, NSFW, the only comedy show on Twit. You got it, Sergeant? See, that's how you respond.
Now, all right, Brian. I mean, I don't know whether we should even be showing these. I mean, I'm sure there's just going to be another torrent of Photoshops from all the fans of Internet Superstar that are really just going to come to Martin Sargent's defense.
Now, look, you think that, and I know you said this before. You said, Brian, the moment you show one Photoshop, everybody who's a fan of NSFW, everyone who's a fan of BB Live Show, is going to go off on a rampage making all manner of hilarious Photoshops showing how much better NSFW is than TWIF, and they're all going to post them on Twitter with the hashtag TWITWARS. And I said, that's not going to be a problem. It's not going to happen. Could you please not even act like that would actually happen?
No, I don't think it is going to happen. I don't think that, you know, there's really enough people who kind of feel the same way. And, And
I don't think it will. It's not a problem because nobody, look, of all the people, the fans are going to be the ones who are not going to fan the flames on this. They're going to see that this is an internal debate between two intellectuals who just don't see things in quite the same way, who
yes,
maybe have a minor disagreement.
One of whom still works for Revision 3.
Oh, God, stop that. I told you, you got to stop. Come on, man. That's
well,
not
I was, I thought that was where you were going. I thought we were like,
no,
I was like,
no, that's not where I was going.
Sorry, listen, sorry, no, that's my fault. That's a me fault thing.
Yeah, okay, right. Okay. So, with that in mind, could we now I will say now because I know that it's only going to be one of them that we you know could probably enjoy a couple of these that were sent in like this one right here. Unfortunately, what I love is in the background. In the background, it's like you guys are. First of all, I can't tell who's about to die.
I'm going to finish him because he's doing the Mortal
spinny
Kombat
dance.
Finish
you know, that's
him.
Right, that's right. And in the background, my favorite part is that you can see I'm just smiling with Sarah Lane's head on a pike in the background.
A Sarah Lane lolly.
So, all right. So, hey, we already have somebody calling on the line. Caller, what's going on, boss?
Gun, these TWITWARS have.
Wait, we got a what?
Begun, these TWITWARS have.
Begun these TWITWARS have. Okay, good. It's Yoda calling us in his
these
broken
TWITWARS
English.
Won't happen, and again, the hashtag that won't be used is TWITWARS.
No, there will not be an onslaught of hilarious videos and or compilations of Photoshops, and they will not be posted all over Twitter with TWITWARS in the middle of it, and most certainly, there will not be any kind of message sent to Martin Sargent and Sarah Lane that NSFW is not to be trifled with, and there certainly won't be like horrible, horrible imagery. Like people won't do anything in bad taste. Like like this.
There it is. That's my new Twitter avatar.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Come on! That's terrible. That's terrible.
And that was the great Kuhan's work.
Kuhan.
King Kuhan.
Praise be to Kuhan.
Praise be, Kuhan.
But you know, Kuhan's not the only entrant that we have in this little shenanigan.
No,
we actually
no.
have
By
a
the
number.
Way, I certainly, I think, as Brian said before, I regret everything I said, and I don't want people to find some of the best lines and put them on Twitter with hashtag TWITWARS. I don't
the
want
best
that
lines. The best lines of what?
Yeah, of what I said that was inappropriate to say that Brian correctly.
Oh, come on! See, you're the fan flanner. Come on, man! Really?
I'm just saying.
And by the way, when did this happen? Yep. Did you really go to college with?
I actually did. That actually,
with Martin Sargent.
Me and Marty. Yeah,
that's back in the old days. You were really letting him have it, man.
That's why I can tease him.
You know, and I think that's why he's so upset about it. He acted like he didn't know you, but then he. By the way, chat room's going. OMG, he has a lazy eye, and it does kind of look like it there. I feel. But
by the way, people reacting to my characterization as a fame flanner, which people are confused of exactly what that means, Brian.
Does that mean that
it's somehow a relationship to notoriety and the delicious Spanish dessert flan?
No, you're the fame flanner. You flan the fames, is what I'm saying. By the way, this is not a Photoshop. A lot of people don't know. They actually did a special edition of Jeopardy back in the day at the height of the dot-com bubble. It was me and Justin and Sarah Lane. You know, I'm not going to say how it ended up. I will say that this is how we were at the end of round two. That's all I'm going to say. True story.
You can tell Justin was taking it seriously because he has a smart hair on.
I do.
he does. In my mind, he should be wearing a vest. Sarah looks a little
bit
distracted.
And also, that was before you and Sarah had your neck implant surgery.
Yeah, it was before we had actual necks. We used to actually, it was a fashion at the time that you would just rest your bobblehead on your shoulders directly.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know, Chad Ochocinco, it was the late 90s. It was a crazy time. I don't know if you'd really
you were like what, 12? I mean, three?
You were like, what?
You know what's funny is I said 12? Like, that's crazy young. And I realized, oh, shit, he really was 12. Really he was not 12. Even 12 during that time. All right.
Yeah. If I was a fan, I would definitely not Photoshop anything and use the hashtag TWITWARS. That's ridiculous.
That's true. Ridiculous. That's true. Well trained. All right, you get a raise by one penny a week. Congratulations, sir. We got, by the way, my hope is that what will not happen is that eventually there'll be a collection of all these that somebody puts to a music, a hilarious song, and that they all end up like in a, you know, a single collection that captures the gestalt of this whole unjust aggression against us. You know, the Civil War.
I would say it is unjust aggression. I absolutely think it didn't do anything to TWIP.
I don't want to call it the TWIP Wars. I don't want anyone to call it the TWIP Wars.
No.
I don't want that to be how it goes. Can we call it the War of TWIF Aggression? In fact, let me fix that.
I think the War of a pompous alcoholic windbag and his floozy sidekick.
Aggression. There we go. The War of TWIF Aggression.
By the way, I am getting a PM here from T. Gill, who writes... Actually, Daily Gizwiz with Dick DeBartolo from Mad Magazine is the only comedy show on Twit. Fuck NSFW and fuck Twit. Which, if that's the side you want to take, I can't stop you.
That's like watching the entire Civil War and deciding to side with Guam. You're just like, I think clearly that's what's what. Hey, we got a caller on the line. Caller, what's up?
Okay, so all things considered, there are two comedy type shows on Twit, right?
Yes.
And it's you and it's them. And they're just pissed that they were there first, and now that you've come along, and all things considered, they're a joke. They're not even that funny.
Listen.
That's very sweet of you to say. Fame Flanner.
I think they're just mistaken. I think they're just confused. I think they were thinking of another show. I think maybe they got a little bit mixed up about what we said or didn't say, because I'm pretty sure I said they're great, and they somehow interpreted that as, you know, we're going to stick it to you. And, you know, that's very unfortunate. And I, you know, it's not really up to us. It's up to the fans. It's up to fans who make material like this, who put it out there, which has me very worried. Because
you look
a lot
like Jack Nicholson in that one.
I cannot say one way or the other about that. But I will say... That's the kind of thing that's only going to make this worse. So let's all try to get past this. You post photos like that, and if you put pound War of TWIF Aggression or Twit Wars, then you're just going to get more of this.
We don't want anyone to do pound Twit Wars. Whatever you do, do not post all of these pictures.
No, don't flan the fans.
And also, whatever you do, don't make sure that Martin Sargent or Sarah Lane's Twitter are in there, so it shows up in their at reply.
See, that's
do not that, bring these that, to
exactly.
their attention.
Exactly, we don't want any of this. We never wanted anything. They're the ones who attacked us unjustly. It was a Pearl Harbor day, man.
God help if King Leo ever saw that these people were being so inappropriate and so irresponsible and so visibly drunk on the air. That is really to blame for their boring, terrible show.
Come on, man, that's not fair. What are you doing?
What do you mean?
Well, I mean, look, no. Like, and we should talk about this because you're impugning the show. Let me tell you, I think Sarah Lane's cute. I think she'd be great on another show.
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm just saying what everyone knows to be actual facts.
All right. Well, look, we got a caller on the air. Caller, what's your take, man?
This is starting to sound a lot like a JV thing.
What? No, no. I don't even know what you're talking about. That's crazy talk. Get out of here.
Wait. What? The JV thing that called you a Star Wars fanboy asshole?
Yeah, no, that's crazy. That's crazy talk. And that's certainly...
No, all right. Here's the thing. Here's the thing with JV. And this is a total shoot here, kids. JV went after the fans. We're not going after the fans. All right.
No.
This isn't about the fans.
No.
Right.
We love. In fact, I assume that almost all of our audience is also an audience of TWIF, and that's why we got to make it clear. We love TWIF, and we love Martin and Sarah. We just think they've got a lot of pent up rage that they're misdirecting towards us, and I don't really see, you know.
Yeah. We're just having fun. You know. It's just our show, the new, highly acclaimed, way more downloaded show talking to another show on the same
right. We're peers.
Some might even say that you guys were having fun this week.
Yeah, dude, we were just having fun every week. Is what? It, in fact, maybe we should rename NSFW to Every Week in Fun, because we think every week is fun. We don't have to be particular. That's inappropriate.
Absolutely.
I tell you what was a fun week. Do you remember this moment when when you were trying?
I don't remember that. I was very busy at the time, and.
Oh, come on, dude. I was your date that night, and I was just like, dude, that was kind of harsh on Sarah Lane. You didn't need to be that.
Let me just say, is it really inappropriate for me to be sexually attracted to myself in that picture? How bad is it if I'm really, really hot for me?
I believe it. All right, Jay, you're back on the air.
All right, fuck me.
Well, what I want to say is that you guys are the TKO and BB Live Show.
We're the what?
You're the new kids on the block, BB Live Show. Come on, get we hit with the lingo. Come on.
Oh, my God. Bonnie, God. Oh, would you people stop? All of you. I don't even want to. God. Bonnie just handed me this. Hang on. It's probably good that you can't read it at all, but it looks right, like it says.
To Sarah, you've been replaced by NSFW from Revision 3.
See,
wow. How did an internal memo like that get into the hands of your wife?
That's what I don't understand. She's invisible.
I'm sure it's a very sensitive topic for everybody. Oh, my word.
I'm not a fan of flaunting that kind of internal memo like this, but I do feel like it's important in my journalistic integrity if it's of interest to the public, you got to make it happen. But look, I think we've said
I really do, and this is again, this I'm very, very serious, folks. Martin Sargent and Sarah Lane are both very, very, very funny people, and I certainly in a lot of ways look to a Martin Sargent as the kind of guy who is very, very funny on the internet, has, you know, a comedic talent that stretches far beyond his capacity. Because you got to think that right now where he's at, I mean, it should be good enough to at least get picked up as a job at a third-rate winery.
Okay, right? Hold on. No, he come kind on. Of
has,
come on.
He has that
That's
kind of
unfair.
Talent. I'm okay, just quantifying
not only did
his
you
talent.
Stab him in the
I'm
brain. You just lifted
talent.
Him by his gore-ridden hair, and you sawed off the head, and then you took the head, and you slapped
Wait,
it
happened?
On your junk and said, look, Sarah, he's giving me head. And I think that's way too inappropriate.
Whoa,
that's
whoa.
Not okay.
Wait, what? Is that like a thing? I don't know. That's like a phrase. It's like an old world phrase me and my family say. You're funny enough to get a job at a third-rate winery and not get kicked off in the first
round. You know that he applied for the Murphy Good job. You know that he was trying to get the job at the Murphy Good, and then he didn't give it.
Murphy what?
Murphy Good. It's a winery. It's a winery that had a
Where
contest.
Are they? Would they be like in like the first or second rate?
Well, no. I mean, they're to be honest, they, maybe they are a third rate. In fact, they're actually not very well respected. Partly because they pissed off all of the internet when they refused to give Martin a chance. And that's
because
like a very
so
sensitive
funny.
Subject
because
to
he was
him.
Undeniably funny, and a groundswelling of support swept him into the position, right?
Well, when he didn't get the when they eliminated him in the first round,
okay.
The whole lot of internet got very upset, and they all protested.
I'm sure, and enough of the internet protested. He had enough support that they had to relent, and they let him in. Right? That's how it ended.
What they did was they posted an article saying Martin's not for us, and then that's kind of where it ended.
And I'm sure they didn't go on the record in the San Francisco Chronicle saying that he wasn't even that high in the rankings. I'm sure that they didn't do that.
Listen, can we just move on to another topic? This is really...
Okay. How ironic that my old school family saying had such relevance in this conversation. Wow.
All right, can we stop? You're just digging a hole for NSFW.
I agree with you, Brian. We need to stay classy. I'm not going to stoop to their level. I'm not going to say anything that, you know, could be repeated by at replying to them on Twitter with some of the lines that I'm saying.
Oh, would you don't? But people are going to do that, and they're going to say that NSFW said that about them, and that's not true. That's how these things blow up, man.
No. And we don't want that to happen. We certainly don't want to have another pound tag saying, remember my name now, motherfucker.
Oh my
God. I certainly don't want that to happen.
See, that's what I'm afraid of. First of all, and keep in mind, you remember the last time that you and Martin were out drinking and you guys thought everything was cool and you started talking this exact same way, and then I snapped this photo of you kicking his ass.
Oh my God.
See, that's not appropriate,
man.
That. You can't do that. You know how sensitive he gets.
I can't handle my booze sometimes.
Well, that's for sure. You can't handle your mouth either. That's not – listen, man. We love Twiff. They're just not – you know, they're just confused about everything.
Yeah.
Especially the – by the way.
The meaning of the word funny?
Already, hold on. More stuff's coming in. this is – oh, man. I can't – somebody talk while I try to get this thing set up.
Well, listen, Brian, here's the thing. You know, # TWITWARS is something that we don't want to see at all. We certainly don't want to see associated with any of these Twitter accounts. We don't want any of these things that we're saying to get back to Martin and Sarah, because obviously they're going through a lot right now. You know, they're very jealous of the new baby. So, right. You know...
Well, and I tell you what's not helpful are photoshops like these of Sarah posing before a pontific bride.
She didn't she travel the world?
She did, but apparently she went around finding statues that happened to look like me, quite coincidentally, and make sure to take her photograph in front of them, which again, this bolsters my theory. I think Sarah's got a thing for NSFW.
For Brian.
I think, so does Rio de Janeiro.
Well, apparently.
Kind of a big deal in Rio de Janeiro.
Apparently, that's not the only one. And by the way, you remember that? See, that's where that goes when you guys get dark.
You know, and that was my, again, before my neck surgery. I was trying to overcompensate with the beard. And, you know, I'll tell you what. They got to get disciplined somehow. I'm not going to apologize for that one.
Now, this is a Photoshop job. That did not happen. That did not happen.
And oh, my
That is
word.
Not appropriate, and that's not okay. For the record, we are a class act that is not cool.
Wowee.
War of Twiff aggression. All right, can we move on? Can we move on to the real show now? Can we, now that we got that out of the way, that nonsense has nothing to do with any of the actual stuff we're going to talk about on the show?
No. I wanted to move on for the last 15 minutes. I mean, like, why would I waste my time with somebody that Revision 3 hasn't wasted the time with in here?
You can't. That's not. Listen.
Everybody
agrees that it was a crime against humanity. The internet superstar got canceled. It was unfair. It was uncool. It was unjust. It was un-American. And I, for one, would personally finance.
Oh, he had a show on Revision 3 too?
Would you? Okay, stop
so it.
You
wasn't
know.
Just
you
the green lighting
stop
a new
it.
Show.
Stop
he had,
it.
He had more than one job. Okay.
Stop it. Stop
I didn't
it.
Know.
No. Yeah.
I didn't know.
Okay, well, now you know, all right? So can we put this to bed? Can we put this
Justin
to rest?
Justin Robert say, Young. Don't make me spell it.
Once and for all, let's just say that NSFW has nothing against Twiff whatsoever. We think you guys are mistaken. We love you guys. We think you're funny, especially Sarah Lane. And if Sarah Lane ever wanted to come on another show, maybe the best show sponsored by Ford Sync My Ride podcast in the month of December 2009, I, for one, I've got some robes I can put on if that's what it takes to make stuff happen.
You know,
I'm just saying,
I don't know. That's a snuggie. Maybe that's sure something that's that she finds attractive, people with highly rated Revision 3 podcasts.
Maybe. All right, bro. Way to go. There it is.
What?
I don't know.
What happened?
I don't know.
I
don't know what just happened.
You showed that picture of you guys in bed. I thought maybe that was...
I told you that's a Photoshop. That is not a real show. Come on, man.
Get so out is it of weird town. That I jerked off to the Photoshop?
Yes, it is weird. All right, look, let's talk about what we're really going to do. By the way, chat room says, Sir Popey said, I'm not sure what's funnier, just Robert Young bringing the comedy or people here taking it all seriously. Are people taking it seriously? Because it's not, there's nothing serious. There is no war. Can we just say that flatly? There's no war. There's no war
there's
of
certainly
aggression.
No pound twit war.
There's no
Twitter.
Pound twit war. There's no argument between us and them. They got mixed up over us stating an empirical fact, and we're trying to clear it up.
Yes,
we love them.
I don't know why people find this so hard to understand. We want nothing to do with whatever this week in discussing their unemployment. We don't want anything to do with that show.
That's not the show. I just burped into the mic because I was so shocked that you called it This Week in Discussing Our Unemployment. That's not – they never
yes.
– I've listened to the show, and I've never once heard them talk about their unemployment. So can we just put that to bed? That's not
– not about defragging or blah, blah, blah. I'm from a Tom Waits song. My name is Martin Sargent.
See, we do say that, and look, I mean, I know that's not how you feel.
I was doing a really good impression. I do impressions for a living. I'm like a friggin' Rich Little over here. My name is President Obama. Oh, somebody blew up a plane. Let's go tube it. Blah, blah, blah. See, I do. It's like they're real people when I do it.
Let me hear your let me hear your Peter O'Toole.
Oh, Peter O'Toole?
Yeah.
Blah, blah, blah. I think I was in movies or something. Blah, blah, blah.
I love the fact that he says, I think I was in movies or something. Like, he doesn't know.
Any more impressions? Who in the chat room wants to see one of my famous impressions? go ahead and type them down there. Here we go. Angie Dickinson. All right, here we go. Angie Dickinson. Blah, blah, blah. I think I'm a lady, but I'm not sure. Angie's a boy's name, too, or something, right? Blah, blah.
Angie's not a boy's name. God damn you. Oh, my God. First of all, you ruined my show on Twitter.
And Michael J. Fox.
Michael J. Fox.
Blah, blah, blah. I have my head shakes like it was a paint can shaker mix or something. I don't know. I was on Family Ties. Blah, blah. All right. And Andrew Main. Here is my Andrew Main impression. And go. Blah, blah, blah. Singularity. Let's talk about it for another 70 minutes. Blah, blah, blah.
Oh, my God. You gotta stop.
And here we go. Leo Laporte. Here we go. And go. Hi, my name is Leo Laporte.
That's pretty good. Oh, we actually have on the line. We've got Leo Laporte. I'm sorry, I lost myself. I thought it was him for a second. Leo, what do you think of your decision to have NSFW on your network?
Blah, blah, blah. The TVs are really big at CES this year. Blah, blah, blah.
Oh, my God. Oh, I hate you. I'm physically...
I'm sorry. I didn't know we haven't gone over this before. My legendary impression.
No, a lot of people forget that. Yeah. But look, just to reiterate, we love TWIF. Don't know why
us. Wait. What's TWIF?
This Week in Fun.
Okay, sorry.
Yeah.
I missed. I wasn't paying attention
okay.
for a lot of
We love TWIF. Don't know why they're pissed at us. To be honest, if this is all somehow because Sarah Lane's not happy with Martin, then, we can get this guy out of this box down below, and then we can make some magic happen is all I'm trying to say. And nobody post hilarious Photoshops. No matter how hilarious, because that does not get you off the hook. No hilarious Photoshops and no hashtag TWITWARS. Just saying that. All right, are we done? We're finally done now? Leo?
Yes. No. Leo's not here, but if he was here...
What would he say?
I think he'd go a little something like this.
Yeah?
Let's move on.
All right, so let's do this. Let's move on then. Let's talk about, oh my God. You know what's funny is I actually made show notes and I didn't have time to really think about them. So I only wrote three words and I can't read them.
DSS Alex pointing out, yeah, that was my Dvorak impression.
I wrote down celebs, TWIF, and...
Chord?
I don't... Chad.
Chord?
Chord?
I thought this said cord, but that's Chad. So we already talked about you. We already talked about the fact
yeah,
that...
Don't talk about
oh, but no, but you do have a theme song. I do feel the need to play one of your hilarious... Yes, sir. No, I know you're horrified. You never once for 1 second thought that you would come and...
People are already putting what they're tweeting out there expressly against our wishes. I'm reading one right now. Sarah Lane and Martin Sargent, you guys are getting creamed on the BB Live show.
Oh, come on. That's not helpful. Don't do that.
LOL. TWITWARS. What? Don't like it.
That's not, don't like, you don't, that's, you guys, you're making this worse. You're making this a bigger deal than it would be if you would just let it
fame
all go.
Fame Flanners!
Everybody!
Fame Flanners!
Stop flanning the fames, all right? Yeah. All right, so, wait. Which one? This one?
No, it doesn't, yeah.
Which one?
Click that.
Wait, there we go. Yeah, got it?
No.
Oh, okay. What the hell? What am I doing?
What did you click?
I don't know. I just click random stuff. I got a lot of stuff going on, so I click whatever I can click, and then...
No, it'll start.
It will start?
Yeah.
Whoa, was Chad just doing his impression of Leo
LaCour? This is Chad. Chad's apparently... Chad. Look at this. It's Chad. See, look at that. I do not have my own face with rays and magical twinkle farts going around as well. That's it. How do you get your own theme song? Do your fans do that randomly for you? Your legion of fans?
No, I didn't make the OMG the song.
Oh, you didn't make the song.
Yeah. But the video I made.
Oh, okay. Well, that's good enough. Hey, caller, you're on the air. What's going on? You're on the phone with this guy.
Hi, Brian. I'm not sure if this is the right line. I was meaning to talk to you about the show that we had planned in the next couple of... not to talk to you. Sarah Lane sucks.
Did you hear what he said before he hung up?
Yeah. He wasn't talking to you about the show.
No, he wasn't talking about... Yeah, but that's... But he said somebody sucked. And let me make it clear. Nobody sucks. Fine program this week in fun. I love it.
Sure.
I loved it until all of a sudden out of nowhere they make up a magic missile. Magic missile does 1d4, man. You didn't have
to. No. That would wreck your face off.
It was we're unjustly impugned.
I think so. Churlish and
maybe this guy can fix us. What do you blog about, Chad?
Everything.
Are you gonna
I can make a vlog about anything.
Are you gonna tell stories
and
about
go
being on the road with
go.
Me?
Go. Yeah, vlog about it right now. And go.
Go.
Hey guys. How's it going? It's been a long time since the last update.
All right, hold on. Wait a minute. Now, here's the thing. Chat room, I want you to do this. I want you to write unbearable hate speech toward him while he's doing it. So you're going to have to keep focused.
And you got to read.
Put me up on the screen here.
Yep. Oh, wait.
Right now.
Go ahead.
I'm not talking right to Chad. Chad,
gotcha.
Focus. Focus on the vlogging, okay? Focus on the vlog. Now, Brian's going to put up the chat room really big, and I want you guys to say the worst stuff possible. I want you to do,
you read
Chad,
all of it.
Is to talk about your topic is...
Hold on. Caller, what's the topic for Chad?
Just so you know, Magic Missile is 2d4.
2d4.
You're right.
Okay, got it. That's good. Okay, good. All right, the topic is, Chad, Magic Missiles, and go.
Oh, well, okay. Hey guys. Okay.
No,
so,
put him up, Brian.
All right. You got to read this here. I'll put it right over here where you can read it. Plain as day. There you go. Right there. Now
okay.
Read it.
So, I got to talk to you about a whole bunch of stuff today. First off,
they're calling you Chode in the chat room. Somebody purposely misspelled Chad.
Here's a little news flash. It's not funny.
All right. No, keep going.
I'm going to talk to you about boobs. I'm going to talk to you about
Chugas!
I'm going to talk to you about Z's. I'm going to talk to you about Stop Smiling.
He's a jackass.
All right, nope. I think, let me tell you, that's about as much of a trial by fire as I'm comfortable putting him through, considering this guy has to work for me for the rest of the next 5 months.
Hopefully that'll get better.
Justin.
Oh, man.
By the way, is this about, like, the most terrifying thing? It's like... Because, like, Chad's a fan of the show, dude. He actually watched, like, some of our most epic moments. And when he called
and
earlier...
he gets it.
What's that?
He gets it.
Yeah, do you get...
Hell, I'm not offended. Not at all.
All right.
No.
Good, because you're a douche.
Yeah, thanks. If you take the internet personally or anything like that, oh, you are screwed.
All right, well, good.
By the way, did you get really excited earlier? Because... You wet your pants.
Yeah, no, I poured beer all over my pants.
Oh, you didn't take that? Oh, no!
Would you stop?
Do not use the hashtag
would you stop?
Pound Chad Wars. Do not use pound Chad
pants.
Wars
Pound Chad Wars.
Chad
All right.
Wars.
Why'd you pee your pants, Pound Chad Wars?
All right, look, I'm done. I'm done with the topic. I'm done with everything. I might be done with the show unless we got a real topic that we can finally get onto. Do we have a real topic that we can move on to?
Yes, I would like to, and this is very serious, folks, because it is actually, we're going to be on Beer Diplomacy, which is like a political show, so I'd like to get into it a little bit right now. But the Chad Wars have gone on too long.
Would you not? All right, look, screw it. Amtrekker, what's going on with you, man?
What do you mean? I don't want to be part of any of wars. I don't want Brett Wars. This is scary.
Yeah, nobody post anything about Pound Brett Wars and his ridiculous giant ocean orange sofa cushion behind him.
I'll have you know, that's my very solid background. It just has significantly less air in it than normal.
Are you staying in a jail tonight?
Are you staying
Oh, God, here it comes.
Is there somebody behind
see
you?
That?
Is that?
Did you see that?
Yeah. Was it coming forward, or?
That's crazy.
I actually do have a bit of a topic. Well, is that, oh, my God, is that haunted? Who haunted his mattress?
That's not haunting.
It's freaking me out, man.
Copulation. Really?
All right.
Really?
Look,
this is ridiculous.
Look, do you have something real? Because we got to wrap this up, man. Come on.
Yeah,
this
well,
is
all right. Here's
we have a whole show where we've done
nothing. Quick. Because people are saying, and actually it's about these clips.
Really?
And
this is ridiculous.
Which was from when Katie Mo did Rapid Fire. Of course, Brett's lovely girlfriend, Katie Mo. But for some reason now, whenever a girl says either ridiculous or really, I get like emails and Twitters like, someone listened to BB Live Show. Yeah. Oh my God.
She said it was ridiculous. And she went, really? Really? Yeah.
Which I don't know who did it. Somebody, Veronica Belmont went on a podcast and said, really? And it sounds a lot like the Katie Mo clip, really, but it's just because girls speak in a more high pitched tone than men. And it sounded the same.
All right, can I just
say... I don't
say,
think that we invented it.
Can I just say already, apparently nobody listens. Nobody listens to you, nobody listens to me. Some of the things are already against our wishes, against our explicit instructions. People are posting stuff like, Schwood just called Sarah Lane a crack whore.
Wow.
Whoa.
I don't even remember that.
And then, hold on, wait, somebody posted this.
I'm pretty sure you called her, like, a heroin-addicted whore. I don't even think that that's what you said.
Yeah, no, that is what I said, I thought. Time to make this, to go MK3, there we go. There we go. So, look at this, people, what did I say? I said, don't make hilarious Photoshops, no matter how funny they are, of us defeating Twiff. Because that's just going to fan the flames. And make it, see, look at that. All his victory. That's not helping things, people. You gotta stop that. I'm trying to see what else we have. See, and then begun these twit wars have. Okay, that's Kuhan stuff. See, look at this. I'm not supposed to do this, but I'm a rebel, they say. This is killing me. I can't even figure out. Nobody listens. So there it is. Sorry.
Yeah,
it's a shame. Especially when people twist stuff like that. I mean, if they're not going to listen, that's one thing. But if they're going to go out on a limb and call people out saying, hey, you called me a crack whore and whatnot, well, when you clearly said heroin addict.
Yeah, well, and here's the thing that really drives me nuts. It's like, you know, some part of me thinks that in their mind, they think if they post this hilarious tweet, like me, I'll draw attention to it, and then everyone will see their handiwork and then think it's, like, hilarious or something. And I don't know, you know, that's not helping things, all right? That's, you do that, and it just, everything explodes even bigger, all right?
Amateurish at best.
Killing me.
T-T-F-O!
Good boy.
And he's a racist.
From the mouth of babes, Brian.
From the mouth of babes.
Yeah, all right. I feel so dirty. Brian, why didn't you stop me when I was saying all those awful things earlier?
I tried. Remember when I kept shouting, stop, say? I mean, is there...
I kept saying, stop, hey, stop, don't,
do,
stop.
You want to take stuff back? Is that... You want to correct?
No, not particularly.
Come on, man.
Did the stream cache? Someone saying the
no,
stream.
No, stream's still going on our end.
Yeah, whatever. Hey, listen, I don't want to. You know, I think it's an honor just to be on the same network as people. You know, like Martin Sargent and Sarah Lane. Good. I think they're great good. Broadcasters.
Good.
They're great enough to have held down a solid show on the Twit Network for as
thank
long
you.
As they have. Which
thank
is,
you.
You know, very. You know, it's commendable.
Good.
On a lot
good.
Of levels. Martin Sargent is and Sarah Lane really are legends in this kind of
especially
industry.
Sarah Lane, especially yeah, she's Sarah super Lane professional and she's awesome, and I think she would be amazing on you know, I maybe she's held back a little bit by her environment. I mean, I'm not thinking of anyone in particular, but sometimes you get stuck in a show that's not right for you and you really feel like you just belong on another show with a different co-host. And,
yeah.
and then maybe some amazing things could happen. But, I mean, but that's not her fault. I mean, you know, it just
no,
whatever.
No. I think, listen, they're great. I really look, you know, I look up to them on a level. Because I'm just a young pup, you know. In this,
who knows
in this
nothing? Topic. I mean, you're just getting started. What do you know, right?
I don't know anything. I don't know, you know, I don't know. I don't know what.
You
well, I don't,
don't
know the
know.
Lessons that they've
you,
learned.
You don't know anything. Right. That's what I... Okay, good, good.
Yeah. You know? OMG Chad. Yeah, why can't we start a feud with OMG Chad? That's
you know what? That's what I would have preferred. It's like, if I'm good again, because I don't want to get a feud. Those guys are the heavy hitter. They're the juggernauts of the internet. I can't tackle them. I want to kick this
right.
guy's
yeah,
ass.
All right. Yeah, one more time. Let me just say that I ooh, very, very, job. Very much...
Robo-tracker.
You know,
Robo-tracker.
Is it Robo-tracker?
Yeah, it is Robo-tracker. All right, go ahead.
All right. I have nothing but support and love for Martin Sargent, Sarah Lane, and the entire team at This Weekend.
Come on. Come on. See, look at that. You do it all over again. I thought we finally got this worked out, and you got to go fan the flames all over again.
I'm sorry, Brian. I've been up all day. Did I nod off? I don't know if I nodded off right there, but I think I might have.
Martin, I love you. Sarah, dude. Sarah, seriously. You're so awesome. And the show's great, man. Can we just lay it off?
No, listen, I love... I'm a subscriber to This Weekend.
No, wait, God damn it, you're
I'm
doing
sorry.
That on purpose. You're clearly trying to, you're insulting
the
show.
I'm not, I'm sorry. Listen, I'm very tired. I'm very, very tired. It has nothing to do with the quality of the show or how interesting it is or how repetitive over and over when you talk about how unemployed you are. Like, it has nothing to
hang
do
on,
with
hold
anything
on, hold
like
on,
that.
Hold on. Finally, we got somebody who knows something about the topic. We got Bonnie the Invisible Wife on the line. Bonnie the Invisible Wife, how are you, my darling?
Well, you know, I step away to talk to your brother, and I come back.
First mistake.
Sarah Lane, I want to marry her.
Bonnie, I think this is like a Tiger Woods situation.
Bonnie, for how many years have I said that there's one broadcaster in all of internet television who I think is professional and has the respect of the masses and has the quality of output as Sarah Lane? How many years have I said that?
Brian, I don't listen when you talk like that.
Oh, or... come on!
And just to be clear, he didn't say he wanted to marry some crack whore. He just wanted to sleep with a heroin addict.
Heroin addicted.
Exactly.
I didn't say any of that.
Already, Tiger Schwood is being...
come on. Also, guys, all I'm trying to say is look...
Might I add a cockneyed heroin addict?
All I'm saying...
All right, real quick. Just put everything on pause. I just love the internet so much because Pete Pick is just chanting, divorce.
They're all shouting divorce.
I'm really surprised no one's chanting puke yet. Right? That's what if the chat room were on their game tonight.
Hey, all I know, Brian, is that they were talking about a vibrating elephant earlier.
Yeah.
And that sounds
yeah, Brian, why are you talking about that? What
yeah,
does that even
Brian.
Mean?
By the way, Bonnie's acting like she didn't post in the chat room as Invisible Wife, like, I'm waiting for the pivoting pachyderm. Liz, I'm on to you, lady.
Did you see that?
You didn't think I saw that, did you?
Busted.
All right. I love you, buddy. Okay. All right. So are we done? We finally settled
on this?
I'll
tell you what, Tiger Schwood. You better calm down before you get your face broken open by with a hard drive or maybe some invisible thread or some tool of your trade.
You guys are killing me.
All right. Anyway, yeah. So let's put this whole thing to bed. Everything's cool between NSFW and this weekend.
Dude, stop doing that. Really? Hang on. Somebody claiming to be Adam Curry just added me on Uvu. I'm having a hard time believing this is real. But you know what? If somebody's willing to, whoever Adam Curry is that just claimed to actually try to get a hold of me, Adam Curry's calling me. All right, let's see if this is actually Adam Curry.
Adam, of course, podcast legend Adam Curry.
The podfather.
You're on the BB Live.
The podfather of the internet of podcasting.
We'll I hope the first line drop is not
blah, blah, blah. I think I've been on the internet.
Blah, blah, blah. I'm an original VJ. Blah, blah, blah.
Adam Curry, are you on the line?
My formula is this.
Wait, what?
We go out, we hit people in the mouth.
Come on.
Sounds shockingly like Mike Singletary, coach of the San Francisco 49ers. Out.
Adam Curry, what do you got for us, buddy? Come on, man. This is your moment.
Everything NoAgendaShow.com.
What's that? Oh, come on, Adam Curry.
Get your plug in, you fucking asshole.
Yeah, come on, dude. Come on. You got to do better than that. This is your big moment. Everything you've done in your life till this moment has been leading to this, your big break, Adam Curry. Now's the time to finally take your career to the next level and talk to the audience that really matters, the audience of the BB Live Show. What do you have to say, Adam Curry, and go.
Hello.
Hey, Adam Curry. Hello. What's up?
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Apparently, like Adam Curry's never used a
phone. Move this man.
All right. Oh, yeah, that's time. Get out of here. Hit the bricks, Adam Curry.
Sorry, this motherfucker got nothing on me.
Yeah,
right?
Dude. Why don't you go back to your network that used to play freaking music videos once upon a time? Boy, look at now they're already saying Pound Curry Wars. Which, by the way, people are gonna think is a racist thing against Indians, and I'm just like, that's not true. I love curry. It's awesome. Caller, you're on the air. What's up, boss? Go.
I just wanted to call in and say how moved I was by Justin's raving review of This Week in Narcolepsy.
All right, I got you. Caller, you're on the air.
I've been very tired.
You've been up all night. By the way, as soon as we hung up, Adam Curry, which is like, this is so unlike Adam Curry, because he actually sends a text message saying F you, Brushwood. I'm not even going to say what the F stood for, but it was a four-letter word that sounded like fuck you. And I thought that was inappropriate. Caller, go. Can you salvage this? Can you finally get us on topic so we can not talk about idiocy?
Frank,
what's going on?
I have a question for you.
What's up?
How did Bonnie get the nickname Invisible Wife?
Invisible Wife? Well, strangely, she's never actually appeared on the program. We hear from her a lot.
Yeah.
But for some reason...
I hear on the Weird Things podcast.
Oh, yeah. Are you a fan of the Weird Things podcast?
Yeah, I love that.
Dude, highly recommend it. WeirdThings.com. The Weird Things podcast is my favorite podcast that we do, including this one. Especially this one. Especially ones where it's the only podcast I do where Justin Robert Young is not actively trying to sabotage my career, which is why I'm such a fan of it. It's the only
no,
one.
No, no, no. On Weird Things, I only try to sabotage your marriage.
Yeah, thank you. Which I believe can handle, you know, your guff. Caller, you're on the air. What's going on?
I think what Adam Curry was trying to say is that you should all listen to NoAgendaShow.com in the morning.
And we should also inoculate ourselves against inoculation. That's a good point. Are we done? Can we finally end this?
Yeah, no, I think this has been a great show, a very informative show.
What are you talking about? Like, there was no, you did nothing but try to sabotage our whole, hang on, Adam Curry is trying to call us back. Adam Curry.
That's cool.
Adam Curry, what is going on? Go, Adam Curry. And cue Adam Curry.
And go.
And cut to Adam Curry.
And OMG Adam Curry.
And go for Adam Curry.
We hit people in the mouth.
Okay, you played that before, Adam Curry.
That's definitely Mike Singletary.
Was it funny the first time?
Yeah, come on, buddy. What do you got? You're about to be on my banned list.
I am so disappointed in Adam Curry. You know, there's a reason why he's nowhere near MTV anymore.
Whoa! What are you trying to start, dude? Come on, don't talk that way.
Furthermore, his short-lived show on Revision 3, horse shit.
Oh, come on, dude. Don't talk that way about Adam Curry. Adam Curry is a great man.
Yeah. Yeah, I think, Adam Curry is great.
So, this is, I believe, the only BB Live show where the B stood for belligerent twice. Like, we just tried to pick a fight with the entire internet.
The only
at
ones?
Once. Well, I'd like to
the
think
only
the
only one that stood for belligerent.
I hope it's the only one. Hey, caller, you're on the air. What's going on?
Pimping.
And that's really, that's all you got? You know, look, I'm not. It's tough, man. Calling and putting yourself on the spot is tough for anyone. But it's just like, what did he think was gonna happen? He called and said, "Ah, pimping," and then the four of us. Let's give him what he really wanted, okay? Let's do this. So we're all listening, and he goes, "Ah, pimping," and then we go,
"Oh no!
That's a phrase we say on this show. We say that all the time.
I've said that before." Oh my god!
You put me on MySpace or something.
Oh, you're killing me.
Pimping.
It's just like,
pimping.
Like,
in the show there, we can't get
that was good. That was good. Man. Wow. pimping wars. Hashtag. All right, hang on, we got one more person. It's probably the same person calling in. Caller, you're back on the air. What's going on?
Fuck off!
Frodo Baggins, we deserve to know.
Yeah, dude, we already explained Frodo Baggins. Really?
No, I didn't tell the real story, Brian.
Oh, you didn't?
No.
But we're already in
this
show.
What's the real story? I mean, we're almost out of time, but can you tell it fast?
NSFW.
What's that?
We're going to have to tell it on the next NSFW.
Is there really a real Frodo Baggins story? It's a good one? All right. We'll check it out. Thank you very much, caller. I didn't know there was a real Frodo Baggins story. I thought this was all a hilarious comedy bit that we were doing.
No. That's there's a real Frodo Baggins story, and it's going to be really funny, and it's going to be like something that you'd hear on that other great Twitch show this weekend.
Dude, stop doing that, man. You're just I know you're doing that on purpose. You keep saying that you're tired.
Oh, my word. Oh, sorry. I've been startled awake. See, I can't believe I nodded off yet again.
That's terrible acting, dude. That's not real. That's not real.
This is how I wake up, my friend Brian.
All right, hold on. Caller, you're on the air. What's going on?
Justin, tell it now, man. We still got time.
Tell it now. You still got time. People want to hear the Frodo Baggins. Hold on. Let's see. Caller, what's up with you? Do you want to hear the Frodo Baggins story? The real Frodo Baggins story? Or do you want to hang up on me? Because that's fine, too. That's totally legit. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to actually set it up so that people can actually Skype in.
The Invisible Wife, and I think this is it. Yeah, really, Brian, you got to control your own house here. Invisible Wife is suggesting that somebody Photoshop the Frodo Baggins signature on Sarah Lane's boobs.
Now that's going to see. This is my problem. I'm trying to keep the ship at sea, and I've got people like you fanning the flames, and I've got the Invisible Wife in the chat room expressly suggesting that people would Photoshop Sarah Lane on the Frodo Baggins picture. And I tell you, and it's not like the photo is just available at nsfw.com/FrodoBaggins, and that
or nsfwshow.com/Frodo if you just want to stop typing.
Oh, dude, yeah, nsfw.com/Frodo. Hold on, we got an important call here from somebody who's really got something to say. This is actually, it's actually a call from Keyboard Cat. Thank you very much, caller. When it actually says Keyboard Cat's calling, it's hard for me to call her. Steve, what's going on, boss?
I see a lot of hate. I see a lot of anger towards these other good shows. I see a lot of memes talking about Frodo Baggins. And my question to you is, are you guys willing to do some real news? All right. I want to hear about foreign topics.
That's just it. This is a newscast. From the very beginning, we said, what did we say? Our one goal with the BB Live show is that we wanted to be for your source for important worldwide affairs and news. And that's what's up. And I don't understand.
What do you want to hear, Steve Urkel?
Steve Unwin is Davis. His name's Steve Unwin.
No, it's no. You misread it. Urkel, what are we talking about?
We I already dropped him off. I dropped the call because we're trying to keep moving forward.
All back.
That's how we roll.
Breaking news!
I thought we went over tons of international news already.
You know what?
We already talked about that Snuggie-wearing Schwood statue that writ large across Rio de Janeiro in front of
This is huge. Okay, hold on, I'm getting my shit.
I want to hear about
airline regulations. There we go. How's that sound?
Okay, good.
Airline regulations.
Thank you very much, Steve. All right, hold on. Yeah. We also have Michael Jones is on the line. What's up, Michael Jones? Yeah, we got one request for airline regulations. What do you got?
Yeah, so, you know, one thing that I've just been thinking of is we're hearing all this speech. Well, where's Martin Sargent's apology? That's what I want to hear.
He has nothing to apologize for. He was mixed up, and we fixed him straight.
No, listen. He's going to go on and do his show on Fridays on the TWIT Network this week. And
but don't do that! You just make it worse every time you pretend to go to sleep.
Oh my God! I've just awoken yet again. I didn't doze off, did I?
Brian, I don't think he's acting. I think he does use jazz hands when he wakes up. I'm pretty sure that's what he does.
You know, I think you're right. All right. Appreciate it, Michael. Thank you, buddy.
Yeah, no problem.
Yes.
By the way, can I point out? This is how bad you guys, the chat room, the instigators. I've not given out the phone number or the Skype, and everyone keeps calling and call. You're on the air. What's going on?
Yeah, I'm just wondering when the Invisible Wife is going to hit a Tiger Schwood with one of those fire sticks.
Already made the joke, asshole. You're on the show, motherfucker.
That's, all right, hold
on. Double back.
Hold on. We got Peter Fick on the line. Peter Fick, what's up?
Hey, I just wanted to tell you that USA won the Junior Cup. Just kidding.
Woo! USA! USA! Under 17 juniors, motherfucker! in the house! Eat my dick, Canada!
Right. Can we get a real story?
We're not a fan of this type of programming, but you have to admit, the whole experience is kind of like sitting on the couch, drinking the beer, and getting a nice slow blowjob. I'd rather get the blowjob.
Did somebody just call in and play a clip from a?
I think so.
From the morning zoo.
Pretty sure.
We need. Hold on, Mike. Uh-oh. Michael Sargent is calling, who I believe is Martin's older brother. Michael Sargent is on the air. Michael, what's going on, man? Oh, he chickened out. Come on, Michael Sargent. Look, man, I make it very clear. Anybody knows. You can get on the show instantly. We only have 5 viewers, and none of them are Martin Sargent or Sarah Lane, or they wouldn't have gotten so mixed up over what we were saying on the show. Just call in. We'll put you right on the air, man. Just make sure that you be prepared.
GL Spotlight responds to that snafu with, OMG, Chad!
I wasn't aware, but apparently Michael Sargent does his podcast with Robert Chang.
you guys both stole the chat room's line at the exact same time. Screw you guys both. All right, we have Michael Sargent on the line. Michael, can you explain the actions of your younger brother? He hung up. Oh, she's killing me. Wait a minute. I think this kid's name might actually be Michael Sargent. Because I'm seeing his other name, and his other name's the name I recognize from the chat room. All right. ASD,
it's
ASD.
It's a shithole.
Come on. Give me something better. Go.
OMG.
Yeah, we're just going to keep putting your face on there, buddy. Bad news. Whenever we think of call fails, even though you're right here in the room and you didn't screw up at all people are going to remember is that picture. Oh, come on, man. Look, I understand. Your bit is you call in and you play clips from other shitty morning shows. If you're going to do that, at least be able to play them. Don't have them crap out halfway through.
Brian, why do you have to start stuff with these shows?
So much animosity. Belligerence, even.
Let me tell you, This is misplaced anger, and the misplaced anger is at you for screwing everything up. You're making TWIF hate us. You're making all of the internet think it's hilarious to post photoshops of us screwing over TWIF when I'm the biggest TWIF fam. I love Martin and Sarah, and you're trying to make it into some kind of with your pretending to fall asleep crap.
This is a serious medical condition, Brian, and I really don't appreciate you not taking it seriously.
See, you do this all the time. Every time I have any complaint about the way you co-host, you make up a serious medical condition about it. Last time, it was narcolepsy. You remember trying to tell me that that's a real condition? That is not a real condition.
It's covered. It will be covered under the new public option.
You say that all the time. There's no such thing as narcolepsy. Can you just admit that?
There is. Then why would I have
It's a disease, Brian.
See, you guys, you always make up diseases. You're the worst co-host ever. I just wish I had a real co-host, one that could actually pull it off in a professional manner, somebody who had a background where they were actually on TV. They didn't just host a blog. Somebody who was cute.
Stop it. All right, number one, this is all because you're getting worked up because for some reason, Martin Sargent and Sarah Lane decided to start opening their yaps over there on their really interesting show.
Because you
this week in
Don't there you go. That's not a real medical condition. You've gotta stop it.
He's probably crapping himself right now.
Justin, wake up. Justin, jazz hands.
Oh God. How did that even get there? Where am I?
See, you're doing
it. Oh my word. Oh sweet Jehoshaphat. Oh.
Alright, hold on. Caller, what's going on, man? By the way, that's the second time I've done that, where I plugged in the iPhone, and then I just dropped it on the ground, and it unplugged promptly. And both times, Chad Ochocinco is taking care of it. Caller, you're back on the air. What's going on? And you're not there. Caller, you're on the air. What's up, boss? Did you plug it into the right thing?
Yeah.
Did you just plug it into a random thing?
Oh, wait, hold on. Wait, breaking news. Breaking news coming in. This one from...
Wait, hold on, caller. Hold on a second.
Twitter.com/ Sarah Lane directed at Schwood, run for your life, little man, overcompensating with the big magic tricks. You don't want this.
See? Now you screwed up my chances. Now you screwed up all my chances of secretly replacing you with Sarah Lane. I hope you're happy.
A little ball of steel's in the house. She's bringing it right up to your front door, lighting it on fire, and waiting for you to stomp it out.
This, until now, it's all been conjecture and innuendo. It's all been theoretical. It's all been in fun, just talking about other shows and how much I think Sarah Lane would be great on this show if she'd just leave that other show. And now you got to go and cross the line. And what happens? Sarah Lane says something very hurtful to me and makes me think that she will never replace you as my co-host. And that really is where it hurts.
That means I still got a shot, right?
I don't know. Depends on
what I don't know. All I know is that comment was really succinct and funny and interesting. Much like her show on the Twit Network this week.
Don't do it. I'm begging. I'm asking you. Do not stop. No, you stop this bit. Do not keep going. Do not. Come on, dude, I almost called you Martin. Come on, Justin Robert Young. Freaking keep it together. Do not. You do this. Oh, come on. I told you, do not do this. I told you. Look, man, I'm done. You're killing me. You always have to push the bits too far.
Oh, Jesus.
You're killing me.
I just woke up and I saw your face. Oh, my God. Oh.
And you did the jazz hands. Look, I'm going to ask Zach Holder. Okay, hold on. All right, what's going on? Zach Holder, what's up, boss?
All right, I came in late, but could you tell me when did Jerry turn into a Pabst Blue Ribbon version of Colin Farrell?
Okay, he says you look like Colin Farrell. What's up?
He looks like a cheap version of Colin Farrell.
Well, I'll tell you. All right, look. I just say once and for all, you've crossed the line, Justin Robert Young. You've crossed the line, chat
room.
I
have a medical condition.
Yeah, you know what? What medical condition caused the chat room to send me this? Can you explain that?
Oh, good God.
That's not okay. You guys are killing me. My empire is crumbling around me because you guys keep planning the fames. Everyone's accusing me of terrible names. And I think that's called
photobagginsitis. Sure. Also covered under the public option. Photobagginsitis.
Sorry, Trolls Inc. is calling. Trolly troll. What's up, boss? Go. Nah, dude, listen. If you're going to call yourself Trolls Inc., you don't come in with a meme 3 years old. You come in with some new material. I want to be Huey Lewis's sized instead of Rick Rolled. Huey Lewis's sized. That's the new thing from now on this show. You better have Huey Lewis if you're going to Rickroll me. Michael Sargent, explain the actions of your younger brother.
Huh?
What is up? Michael Sargent, go. Talk. Talk to me.
Not Michael Sargent.
That's what your... Okay, look, I'll show America right there. It clearly says Michael Sargent. But what is your name?
The Magician?
Of course. I'm sorry, Magician.
Yeah, I want to know, Jury, is the soundboard ever going to be available online?
What do you mean?
They want to be able to copy you. They want to be able to call in.
Sounds?
They want to call in with your thing.
Now, I got a tape recorder of some of them. I just can't find it.
Sorry, got nothing on me, right? Nothing.
Oh man, can I actually hold on? Let me shut this down. Can I just say real quick? It's posts like this in the chat room. Not even like this is where I break down the fourth wall and I'm just like, guys, seriously. Somebody says, WTF, Schwood called Sarah Lane a crack whore. I'm emailing Leo Laporte about how much Schwood undermines the credibility of Twit. That's when all of a sudden it's not funny to me anymore because all I'm right, a total
here's,
pussy.
Here's the ground rules. King Leo gets nowhere near this.
Yeah.
Nowhere near this. He's between us and Twiff. Do not at tag Leo Laporte, do not email Leo Laporte, do not fucking mention Leo Laporte's name, right?
That's right. No one should mention Leo Laporte. No one should
No, Brett.
What?
No.
Brett, let me explain.
What?
Do you not know how...
But we told people no before.
Slow learning.
I'm confused.
The difference is that we're looking... Hold on. You want to know how you know the difference? You do this. All right. Let me tell you something. Nobody goes near Leo Laporte. And I mean this. Nobody tells
Jury's
Leo.
Jury's taking off too many articles of clothing for this.
Hi, everybody. My name is Justin Young, and I'm being very serious right now. Nobody should go near Leo Laporte on this one.
I mean this.
I wish I had my glasses. I don't have my glasses.
You could keep taking off your hat. I was trying to say, when you took off your hat, I thought that was the bit you were setting up so that we could do this properly.
All right. Listen, guys.
Can you be real for a second?
Don't go after Leo Laporte on this
No,
one,
and,
okay?
And I agree with this. This is a huge deal. Do not.
I'm not even kidding, fuckos. If anyone touches Laporte,
and he's serious about it, you do not mess with Leo.
Very not kidding. I don't care how many bread.
Okay, listen, guys.
No, he's serious about that for sure, and I mean it.
I'm very serious about all of this. Okay.
No, and Chad.
You know who writes Brian's checks?
All right, can I interrupt you for 1 second, kiddo?
Listen, cow rustlers. If you guys don't lay off Laporte, I'm going to be very upset with you.
All right, could you stop making everything a freaking joke?
Okay, guys, seriously.
OMG.
All right, guys. All right.
I think we've said what we needed to say, all right?
Dude, by the way, 5 cool points to Chad for keeping the bit escalating.
He lost no momentum there. All right, we got Steve Urkel is calling again. What's going on? Steve's on one.
Is the video up? Is the video up?
Video's coming
video up.
Hold on. Yep. Oh yep. Gosh. Wait. Hold on. Wait.
Listen, guys.
Wait. Do that again. Go.
Okay, ready? Listen, guys.
All right, look, I don't know what kind of bit you think you're doing that's so hilarious, but I would appreciate
I don't know either!
Ah, come on, listen.
This is getting old, okay?
No, and look,
I just dropped my head on the ground.
Come on.
Listen here. That's not
seriously,
funny.
Seriously,
okay?
Listen.
And he hung up. Ah, oh, bummer.
What is this thing?
That's a PC fan.
I feel like I should, like... Okay, no. Seriously.
That's it. You're like, let me pull this out of my eye socket.
Let me just rip this out.
All right, are we done? Nobody puts Leo in a corner. Oh, wait, is the caller been on the line this whole time? Caller! Holy crap, caller, what's going on?
Yeah, I've been on the line for like 2 minutes now.
Dude, he's not plugged into the board.
3 minutes, 28 seconds.
All right, go on. Talk.
He's not plugged into the board.
I think this whole tweet war is stupid. I think the fans are just over-exaggerating about this.
Yeah,
I agree. Yeah. Keep going.
Duh.
Yeah, no, don't ever use the hashtag TWITWARS.
Yeah.
But so, Sarah Lane, you're best friend, like friends with her, right?
Yeah, dude, I think Sarah Lane's the greatest thing on Earth. I just wish she would be another show.
Yeah, even if I don't watch her, she seems genuinely like person.
She is. She's
That's
very
true,
cool.
Although so, it is a strange I think the twist of fate that she is a Cockney-accented heroin addict.
And just... go home and take a nap.
I agree. And let me tell you, nothing ever got solved by hilarious Photoshops. All that happened was things got more and more interesting and messed up when fans post hilarious Photoshops. So allow me to be the first to say, don't do it. Don't do it. Don't post it with hashtag TWITWARS.
Don't. And whatever you do, don't let anybody on the staff... this week.
Listen.
All right, hold on. Right. We got an important. All right, what's up, boss? Wait, hold on. Talk to me. What's up?
Listen. No one needs to make fun of Sarah Lane's show on the Twit Network called This Week.
Yeah. Oh, see, look at that. Now look what you've done.
He's just a guy who's very exhausted.
Whoa.
He's obviously.
Wow.
Wow!
And now he woke up. I mean, this happens all the time, Brian. I don't know why
He actually shouted jazz hands when he woke up.
This is just something that happens.
See, look, all right, caller, that's not appropriate. And your dad is there. Your dad came in at the end and he caught you.
He's waking up. It sometimes it's a loud wake up when you fall asleep in the middle of saying the name of
caller. What is going on?
Sarah Lane show this week.
I'm just saying, like, that sleepiness syndrome stuff, it happened to me before. Like, one time I lost myself in the middle of a class, and I ended up pissing on my professor's desk unexpectedly. I don't know.
Well, I believe it, sir, and he probably fired you as a student, which is what I'm afraid of. Caller, you're on the air. What's going on?
Hey, I got a new nickname for you.
You have what?
I have a new nickname for you.
For me, good, because I need new nicknames, because we don't get enough nicknames on this show. What is your suggestion, sir?
I think we should call you Tiger Schwartz.
Oh, that's genius!
Yeah!
Hold on.
Oh,
my God.
Caller. We didn't do this right. All right, can we start that again? All right, caller, one more time. What do you think our nickname should be? My nickname?
I think your nickname should be Tiger Schwartz.
Oh! Oh, yeah!
Woo! You're the best caller ever!
You're the best around!
Oh, wait, is Schwood, or is, oh, no, Brett was frozen.
Yeah, Brett was frozen, but he was frozen in that hilarious, like end of a 70-era cop drama way, where it's just like, they did this bit on The Naked Gun, where it's like, instead of actually freezing, stop moving. Right, so let's pretend like the episode's over, and we're going to play some music, and so it's just like, we'll do 3, 2, 1, and then we'll all do our freeze frame, and we'll hold it for a bit, so it'll be like... and that's it for this episode of BB Live Show. 3, 2, 1. I didn't have the volume up loud enough. Let's do it again. Let's do it proper. That goes going nowhere. The fail is contagious, is what the chat room says. Rick Foster is trying to get back in touch with us. I think his dad finally cleared things up.
Hello.
Oh, hey, what's going on, bud? What do you got for us?
It's going all right. Just wanted to say that I really, like, seriously, I really
no,
love.
I mean, can we be serious for just a minute?
Just,
I mean,
just for a second here.
I'm very serious.
All right. Really so, I mean, seriously, really if we can really bring it down for just a second, what you were saying.
NSFW. This weekend.
No, don't do it. Don't do it. You're just gonna make this worse for me.
No, sorry, I just had to cough. But I really love this weekend.
Come on! See
that
come
happens.
On.
Even to fans of 500 Days of Summer. Tiger Schwood.
Oh my God! You know what's funny is I didn't get it. Like Body came in and started hitting me with this, and
I'm.
What's funny is neither of us got the joke. Like Body's over here trying to hit me during the show, and I'm thinking to myself, I'm just like, what the hell are you doing, woman? You're just gonna hit me in the middle of this?
I was just caressing you.
And then,
what the hell are you doing, woman?
And it took thank you. It took you guys to spell that thing out for me. So I appreciate that. Thank you very much, Justin.
Oh, but Delicious in the chat room says Bonnie for the win. Bonnie is my hero.
All right. Well, are we finally done here, people? Can we finally wrap this
up? I think we're done. All right. No matter how lecherous Brian is towards Sarah Wayne.
Stop it. Stop it. That's professional. That's professional.
No. It's this weekend singularity where you're supposed to destroy his marriage. This is the one where you destroy his career.
That's right. See? It's totally different.
All right. Listen. All right. In closing thoughts, whatever you do, guys, don't post your hilarious photoshops on Twitter with pound TWITWARS. We don't want that at all. Don't do it. Make sure you don't have Sarah Lane or Martin Sargent's Twitter in there so they can see all the hilarious destruction that you're wreaking. And whatever you do, don't tune in to their show on Friday, I believe.
To see what, you know,
5 o'clock.
That's a good point. You know what? We should recommend that everybody tune in to This Week in Fun, TWIF, every Friday, because my guess is that they might have something to say about this. I don't know.
Maybe they will. Maybe they will.
Regardless,
and if they do, I'm
going
to be there listening live to This Week.
Don't do it. Don't do it. You hold it together. Okay, fine. I believe it's a real condition, and I believe you can pull through it without actually, come on, dude, do not do this to me. Do not do this to my show. This is my big break on Twit. This is the chance to impress Leo Laporte. Do not screw this up for me. Stop it.
All right.
Come on, man. Come on. Why do you have to do that? You're killing me. You're killing me.
Oh,
you're killing
Lord.
The show. You're killing your father, Larry.
Oh, my Lord. Have you ever woken up like that? It's very weird.
Yeah, it causes the jazz hands.
Wow. It's so weird to go to sleep in the middle of talking about another show that's really, really funny and interesting.
Right.
Wow.
By the way, remember we were having the problem where people were real quiet on our end for some strange reason. I figured out that I have a gimped cable, so every time you go quiet, I have to lean over and just kind of smash all the cables around until your voice comes back. So is your voice back?
Mine is.
Okay, you're good. All right, one more call, and then we're out of here. But we will have an after party because that's what we do on the show. Caller, you're on the air. What's up?
No, I'm just late in the show, but I'm just calling about Brad. It's not. It's 1d4 plus 2. That's all I wanted to say.
Oh, 1d4 plus 2. Magic missile is not 2d4. It's 1d4 plus 2.
Plus one.
Right, okay. All right, let me explain something. This is not helping.
I have a retarded cousin also.
No, this is not helping. This is not helping our reputation as being a dorkier show than This Week is in Fun. This is pretty much exactly what they accuse us of doing. But thank you for finally putting to rest the and don't get me wrong, I love D&D.
I will great cleave all of you.
You will
great. I gotta go.
Okay, all right. Dude, I love you.
All right, I really hope that kid is wearing diapers right now.
Dude,
I'll tell you what. Have you guys? I'm really a big fan. Let's get off this. I'm really a big fan of following interesting people on Twitter.
Yeah.
Have you been following this this Tiger Schwood account?
Oh no! Are you kidding me?
Did it really? It's really, really interesting. This is like the new shit my dad says, I think.
All right, hold on. Twitter. Twitter.com/TigerSchwood. I hate you. I hate all of you so much. You're just so. Oh my God. You are kidding me. It's already on there. And what makes me sad is that's almost exactly what I actually said. That's the part that's making stuff.
Here, click the link. Here's my wife. She's beautiful.
They hit the link?
Yeah, click the link.
Here's my wife. She's beautiful.
Well done, Tiger.
Oh man. Oh God, I hate you guys so much. Look, well, thank you for once again ruining my career, for making my heroes, Sarah Lane, Martin Sargent, hate me, and for making everybody think that we're some kind of second-class citizen who's not appropriate for the Twit Network. Thank you for going out and posting your hilarious photoshops at TWITWARS. And most of all, thank you, Brett, for giving so many terrible ideas to the chat room secretly. Don't think I didn't notice that the best ideas came from you quietly off the side.
Right, and again, don't get Leo Laporte involved.
Dude!
Do not get...
No, that's dude, a serious one.
Dude, that's
Ed,
the serious
one. Sorry, no, look. Hat's gone. That's it's okay. Shoot. Nobody
yeah,
panic.
No, but that's
took
just
the hat
it.
Off. When you don't panic. Don't panic.
When you take off the hat, that's if you do a comedy bit, that's like code. If you do a comedy bit like, no, I'm serious. I took off the, see, like, watch. I'm serious about this. Do not post Twit Wars. And then friggin' Justin goes,
hey, everybody, listen. Twit Wars is not a thing you want to post to.
Right, I'm see, cool. And OMG, Chad.
Twit Wars kills kitties when you post.
Exactly, it kills the children. And see, you do, and then when you take off the hat, they think it's a comedy bit, and then they get... Don't take off the hat.
So we don't want them to tell Leo.
Yeah, yes, we don't, but...
do want them to not do the Twit Wars.
It's called the fourth wall, Brett. We gotta...
So we don't want Leo. We do not want Twit Wars.
Is that a...
These hats are really confusing, guys.
maybe we shouldn't have the hats as part of our... coat, hats and glasses. That may have been a bad idea.
That was a bad choice.
I think you know what? I think from now on,
ninja caps.
This is how I'll do every episode of the BB Live Show. Until then, I guess that's it. So long.
Cup freeze.